gentlemen are doing a wonderful job. Sorry. Traffic coming into the city. Price of progress.
This is Dean Walker from Annika. Who's this?
The smoking gun. Ooh, that sounded dramatic.
Leonid Jobin. This is the new evidence you were talking about. Ex-Minister Jobin hasn't been in power for 20 years, and with all due respect, sir, the man is not mentally well.
Perhaps not, but in a mad world, only the mad are sane.
Kurosawa.
What the hell is he talking about?
History, Mr. Walker. My new friend knows a great deal about the history of your company's pipeline.
History is not new evidence.
Or maybe it is. As it turns out, we do agree on one key detail. Your company's current pipeline is not the worst thing on Earth.
Then what is?
The first pipeline. The one Annika built in 1988. 4 years before the current one.
Is that what he told you? The man is delusional.
Probably.
There was only one pipeline. We broke ground to build it in 92. Read the contracts.
You're right. The contracts do say that.
It started before the wall fell. Uzbekistan was still a constituent republic of the Soviet Union. Mr. Gorbachev was changing our future. I was allowed to secretly open our markets for an American pipeline.
This is fiction.
I sold the rights to them that year, and they built the first pipeline right away. You couldn't even wait to do it right. We were all so greedy.
The first line was an unmitigated disaster. Hundreds were killed.
Whole villages became ill. I still see their faces.
Then the Soviet Union collapsed and all hell broke loose. Annika paid Mr. Jobin to orchestrate a cover-up. Bury the dead. Destroy any record that the first pipeline ever existed. It wasn't the only disaster cloaked by those momentous events, hidden from view in the fog of a new world order.
It's a good story, but that's all it is, a story from a crazy old man.
Who happened to keep a complete set of the original documents in the hope that one day he might find the courage to set things right. Your engineers did better the second time around. At least this one took 20 years to start leaking.
If this is true, and Annika is responsible for hundreds of people's deaths, then you and the other high-level executives will be prosecuted.
Reparations can be paid to the alleged victims. We can fix this.
Reparations are all well and good, but the people I represent don't want you to fix it.
They don't?
No. The Uzbek people have had quite enough of Annika's promises. They want you to leave. Pack up your pipeline and leave.
That won't happen.
Mr. Denisov thought you might need some additional incentive, so Mr. Jobin was kind enough to direct him to one of the mass graves where victims of the first pipeline are buried. His men are on their way there now. I can stop them if we have a deal.
Can I get some water, please?
Oh, yes, of course.
This is the water they drink in the villages, the ones directly above your pipeline. Drink up.
Talk to your board. You have 24 hours until we go public.